it's Lindsay from My Crafty Plans. Today I'm going to be planning the week of October 11th in my memory planner, which is of course my R. Estelle A5 wide cloud planner. We went to the farm this weekend to get all of our pumpkins and all of that fun stuff. So I have this amazing kit from Crest Press called Pumpkin Season, which I specifically bought for whichever week we went to the farm, which ended up being this week. So really excited to get to use this. So cute and very different that vibes than most of the fall kits I bought, which were like a lot more floral and delicate foiled type kits. So I'm excited to get to use like another more sceney fashion girl type kit for this week. Anyway, here are the full boxes. This is the essential size kit. So you do get a lot of functional stuff. Two full pages then, plus more stuff mixed in with the glitter headers, all of your sidebar stuff, your bottom washi with an extra full box with all those pumpkins, super cute. And then this square page with the deco. And as well, it came with these extra full boxes, which have different hair colors, skin tones, and then also this pumpkin carving one, which I really, really love that box. And I definitely think I'm going to use that. Anyway, I am going to go ahead and pull out these pages and jump in.
It's, of course, the week we went to the farm. I've been saving this kit for that week, whichever week it was going to be. We had like tried a few different weekends. We were just trying to figure out the schedule, but we wanted to go when it wasn't like raining, obviously, although it was a little bit muddy. Honestly, it was fun, but we had so much more fun last year. And I don't know if that was just because like last year it was still like early COVID days and we like didn't have any activities ever. And I was so happy to have an activity for the kids to do, but we still had fun. We did apple picking and pumpkin picking the same day. And last year we had split it, and it honestly, it works a lot better split up. Plus, end of October, or like mid-October, is a little bit late in the season for apples here. And we had to walk so far to get to trees where the kids could still pick apples off. So honestly, I kind of just wish we had skipped the apples and just done the pumpkins, because I think that would have made it like a little bit less exhausting and a little bit more fun for everybody. But the kids are, they have this book that's like about apple picking, and they read it like all year and are so into the idea. So, and we hadn't gone in September this year. So I think next year we'll split it up. We'll do apple picking in September and pumpkins in October. It just works a lot better. Plus the farm is like not crowded at all in September, and obviously mid-October it was packed. But we still had a good time, and they have like a really cool playground there, so we were able to do that and just, you know, bought a bunch of pumpkins, a whole lot of pumpkins of all different shapes and sizes. I ate some good apple cider donuts and all that fun stuff. And my dad came with us, which is always a good time. And then we went out to lunch after. And it was a really nice day, even if it was like not as like, I don't know, last year I was just like, apple picking is the best, pumpkins are the best, why don't we do this all the time? And this year I was like, okay, that was fun, I'm good for the year. So anyway, I absolutely love this kit. I thought the scene was so cute. I love the girl on the extra sheet with the red hair, because the hair matches the barn like perfectly. So I had to use that one. It was just too perfectly color coordinated. And I just really, I don't know, I was very happy using this kit. I've been doing so many of like the more delicate floral kits lately, which I super love. But every once in a while, if I plan in like one style for too long, I really start to miss sort of the other style. So I do like to mix it up. So I have this kit. And then my Halloween kit and my Thanksgiving kit are both very sceney. But other than that, most of my fall kits are more in that like delicate floral style and foiled for fall. And then I'm just starting to buy winter kits now. So we'll see what we do. I might try and do like a little bit more of both, like a little bit more of a mix, especially because like florals in winter, I mean, they're really pretty and delicate, but also just like not when flowers are, at least not here, because it gets cold. And then, yeah, I got to use a bunch of the Simply Gilded washies, the pumpkin washies, so I was really happy to use those. And I did not do like full bougie boxes or anything this week. I am going to use some overlays and stuff like that, but I didn't go all out with the bougie boxes. And I actually think that it looks so nice. I love the way this came together. And I used just some like really simple foil dividers, and then just like a little bit of fall deco in here to kind of bring it all together. I just really love how this looks, and the colors are so bold and pretty. I'm just putting the overlays on. Oh no, I'm just doing the headers now, obviously. And then I like thought about trying to do the deco at the top above the date covers. That is like, I have a couple of things on like my planner planner goals, my memory spread planner goals. And for this style of spread, one thing that I really do want to try is that thing where you put all the deco on the top and then like kind of trim it. If you know what I'm talking about. I know like Samantha Plans and Reads does it that way, but she doesn't use the date covers, and I want to do it with the date covers. I feel like I don't know if I've seen anyone with a plan with me that does it that way, like to watch them in a video, but I've definitely seen pictures of it on Instagram, and I think it looks really cool. The deco is like too big, and I don't know how to do it. So I'm still trying to figure that out. So that's my memory spread planner goal for this style of spread. And then I still really want to do the like full on like plan, mosh plan, gathered plan style, where you only use the like two headers, one at the top and one over the full box, and you kind of do the full boxes as you go along. I don't know if Gathered Plans does that, but I know Plan Mosh Plan does that. So anyway, those are like my two memory plans, planner spread goals that I will hopefully accomplish. maybe I will try the deco at the top for Thanksgiving, because I have a Scribble Prints Co. kit, and her kits always come with a lot of deco, so I could try that out for Thanksgiving. I think that would be fun. But anyway, as a compromise, since I couldn't figure out how to do the deco, I used a little bit of the foil deco on the corners of the date dots just to make it look a little bit more extra special for fall. And I do actually think that looks really cute, and the orange washi at the top looks nice too. And on the second full box that I used in the sidebar, I have all of these Halloween overlay quotes, and they're in gold foil. I just had gotten them in like a really old grab bag from Artbox Stickers, and I just decided to pull one in because like I'm never gonna use them, and I feel like my Halloween kit for this year is definitely a silver foil kit, but I feel like it almost always is. I think it was last year too, so I have all these gold quote overlays that I haven't gotten the chance to use, so I just put one down, and it says something wicked this way comes, and it's on the jack-o'-lantern one, so I feel like that works super well. So anyway, that's cute, and it's at the bottom, not at the top. I wasn't going to put the quote on top of the girl because I just love her too much. I think that's probably one of my favorite like fashion girls in a kit that I've seen in a while. The hair and the cozy sweater, just, yeah, definitely. Anyway, on the day by day, we still had a regular week to get through before we went to the farm. So on Monday, I had work and my husband had a professional exam. So I marked that. I actually think that is the last one he has to do for his, like, he's just been working on this licensing thing. I mean, he'll have like continuing education stuff, but I think that's like the last big test that he took. And then this week was the week that I spent cleaning up the basement and like clearing out the basement to make space to bring stuff from the house down to the basement. I am 98% done with this declutter project. The last thing that I have had to do as of right now while I'm recording this voiceover, by the time this video goes up, it will definitely have already been done. And I've been sharing it on my Instagram stories, and I have the kitchen saved on a highlights reel if you want to see that, because I did a like Pinterest inspired kitchen cabinet makeover. I would say pantry, but we don't actually have a pantry, but like a pantry style makeover. And I bought like all of the food storage bins, and we labeled them and this whole thing. And I cleared out a bunch of stuff from the kitchen. Anything that we don't like use a lot, like all of my fancy baking pans that are all different shapes and crazy stuff like that, or appliances that we rarely use, we put them in like clear bins, and we're keeping them in the basement now. And so I can always go down and get them. Everything is like stored very clearly, but it's not cluttering up our kitchen, because I felt like we didn't have enough food storage, even though our kitchen is very large. And I can't believe the last thing I have to do is just like a little teensy bit of more of the food, and then the like the utensil drawers, but that's it. I'm just waiting for the rest of my bins to come. But I can't believe how much more space we have. It's amazing. I'm so happy with how it turned out. I'm sure you will hear me mention it again when we get to the week that I did that in, because it was not this week. This week was the beginning of the project when I was cleaning up the basement to make space for the kitchen stuff, and also just like get the basement in order. But anyway, so yeah, it was really, I'm really happy with it, and you can check out my Instagram stories, and it's saved to my highlights if you want to see what I did in the kitchen. It came together so nicely. Anyway, so I just listened to some audiobooks and painted nails on Monday, and then on Tuesday my daughter had an OT appointment. We went and got like coffee and breakfast like we always do, and then I took the kids to school. And then when we got back, I actually took the baby for a walk in the stroller because the weather was super nice and we just wanted to get outside and stuff. And then I did some planner stuff that afternoon. I just didn't even mark anything else that day. It was just pretty chill. Yeah, kind of regular. And then on Wednesday, I went to Starbucks. So I was supposed to, I took the kids to school and then my husband was taking his car for inspection and I was supposed to like pick him up and then take him to work. But I got like caught in the carpool line and then had like placed a Starbucks order while I was in the carpool line because I didn't realize how late it was. So I went to Starbucks and then like by the time I was like 5 minutes from Starbucks and my husband was like, I'm all done with my car. I'm just going to walk to work, I think, because it was like only a 10-minute walk. And I was like, by the time you get to the car place, I could have already been at work. So he ended up just walking to work. And then it was really nice weather and stuff. And then I did more work in the basement that day. And I cleaned out all of like our storage closets upstairs and I cleaned out the whole kitchen. The kitchen took the longest and did that process that I described and took all of this stuff down to the basement. And I organized everything in the basement in bins. We bought two like large shelves that are like those really sturdy kind that have like the sort of like crisscross plastic bins. I don't know. It's like the first thing that comes up on Amazon if you Google basement shelves. But yeah, between like the office and the kitchen and the basement, I swear I must have bought like $500 worth of bins. But anyway, on Wednesday, I had just done like some work, some audiobooks, and then I took a bath that night, which I accidentally marked as planning first because I looked at the wrong day and then I switched it to be a bath. Anyway, on Thursday, I cannot keep focused today. I'm just too excited about the house organization project. Honestly, it's amazing. Anyway, I'll stop talking about it now. I went to Target and Michael's on Thursday. We were looking for some last Halloween costume supplies. My oldest went as a witch, my son as a dog, and then the baby was supposed to be a cat, but she absolutely refused to put on the costume or any part of it, and in fact learned to say no tail in a very shrill voice. So that was not the most successful Halloween costume ever, but still had fun. Anyway, the baby was also so cranky this day, and then she took a really long nap, and I just like hung out and did some office stuff, and then that night we got takeout from Thai food and we just watched some TV. So Thursday night, usual, we pretty much have like a rotation of like Thai food, Korean food, and Indian food that we kind of just work our way through on Thursday, and every once in a while we mix it up for something else, but those are the big three. On Friday, I did some more work. I've just been really busy at work lately, and actually you still coming all the way into at least early November, I'm going to be busy. And then my husband came home for lunch and I ate lunch with him. I did some more like tidying up in the office and around the house in the basement. And then that night we just hung out and watched TV. And then I took another bath. And I think I had actually started a cider earlier in the night and I forgot to finish it. I just like put it down. So then I just drank it in the tub. So I used the wine in the bath munchkin just because. I mean, I don't usually if I drink it, it'd just be at dinner. But I had just put it down half full to do something with the kids and then kind of forgot about it. So I finished it later. And then Saturday, I just like must have slept really bad the night before, probably because I was drinking in the tub so late at night, which is not something I usually do. Usually if I'm gonna have a drink, it's at like 6 p.m. But anyway, so I was just feeling very blah. We went to Starbucks and then the kids had their flu shot clinic, so we just did like this drive-by flu shot clinic at their doctor's office, which worked really easy. It was like the whole thing took less than 10 minutes. It was great. And then my daughter had soccer and actually all her grandparents came to soccer that day. So that was super fun. And then I hung out in my office that night and I organized my bead collection, which sounds so weird to say, but I did. I bought like one of those bead sorter bins at Michael's. They have like the little teeny tiny containers and it's like in like a little shelf. And all of my beads were like kind of in four bags, like semi-grouped by type, but not like super sorted. And I sorted them all into these bins and it looks really nice. And yeah, it's hopefully inspires me to do some more like charm making and stuff soon. And I like put aside the ones that I didn't think I was going to use to let the kids play with and make jewelry and stuff since they like to do that. So it worked really well. I'm glad. It took like forever, but it was also just like really satisfying. And I was listening to an audiobook at that time. So I did that as well. And then Sunday was our farm day and we just did the apple picking and then the pumpkin patch. Then we got lunch afterwards with my dad. And then that afternoon, we just did our usual meal prep and hang out with the kids, make dinner, etc. And then my husband and I just watched TV that night, probably SNL. We usually watch SNL on Sundays because there's no way I'm staying up that late. And we actually don't have like live TV. We don't have cable. We just have, you know, like Hulu. So we just watched it the next day. So that was nice. And then I had started on Tuesday because I didn't want the two pencil munchkins to be so close to each other. And I was going to do that thing where you start like on the left side of the column with the icon and then on the right side and then on the left. But since I had forgotten for the rest of the week, I decided it was easier to just move Tuesday because it was, I just couldn't stand the way that it looked with just one being opposite. So I'm just moved Tuesday back to be starting with everyone else and just have to deal with the fact that there are two pencil munchkins right next to each other. It's fine. They're, at least they're not the same one. But anyway, I'm just going through with a little bit of the dividers. I have ones from Sadie Stickers, which are the really thin ones. And then the thicker ones are from Rose Colored Days. And just filling this out and, you know, using lots of scripts and all that stuff. And yeah, I've just been writing with either the Simply Gilded pens or just like gel pens lately. I'm just really feeling it lately. I'm sure I'll go back to my fine liners eventually. But I just really have been liking the way that the gel pens write lately and the way that my handwriting looks in them. So I am going to stick with that for right now, at least. But yeah, it was a fun day at the farm and a fun week. And I wore a really cozy sweater to the farm because it was a pretty cool day. This part of the month, the weather was like going back and forth between like hot and cold, like the way it does in fall on the East Coast. But now we're like firmly in the cooler weather and I'm in a very cozy sweater today too while I'm recording this voiceover. And it matches the spread really well. The colors from my sweater match the spread. I bought like four really cozy sweaters this year and three of them are like so fally with like the oranges, or one actually even has leaves on them. I was just really feeling the fall cozy sweaters this year. So that's really fun. I like never buy clothes, but I did just go through my closet as part of like this house cleaning stuff. Although I'm pretty good about going through my closet regularly, to like do giveaways, like pile clothes for like giveaways or to, you know, throw out things that need to be thrown out. So yeah. And now we just have to actually get rid of this stuff because I have like 10 huge bags of stuff, especially like baby stuff that we just need to take. It's like in the middle of the basement right now, but we need to just take it for donations. So that will work perfectly. And then our house will be all clear and it all needs to be done before Thanksgiving because we are having a lot of people.
Okay, that is everything all finished up. I absolutely love how this looks. Such a fun spread and such a fun week. Let me give that a little wiggle for you and let me show you what I have left from the kit. So I do have a bunch left. There's so much stuff included in this kit. I do just wish there was like a little bit more stuff of the label size or some little things, but I still made it work. There's plenty of quarter box size stuff anyway. This is that, and there were some extra full boxes and everything like that since there were so many extras included. But I just, yeah, I really love this. So fun. Perfect fall farm week spread. So anyway, that is everything for this video. So if you liked it, please give it a big thumbs up. I'd love it if you'd subscribe and check me out on Instagram @mycraftyplans to keep up with everything going on in my planner. Bye!